Welcome to episode 228 of Angela Watson's Truth for Teachers. I'm your host, Angela Watson, and I'm here to speak life, encouragement, and truth into the minds and hearts of educators and get you energized for the week ahead. Today, I'm going to share three steps for regrouping after an absolutely wild school year, and I'll talk about where we go from here. Visit truthforteachers.com to get the transcript or find our Truth for Teachers podcast community on Facebook. You can share your thoughts on the show there and reflect with other listeners in our private group. I want to thank Advancement Courses for sponsoring today's show. You can earn graduate credits or CEUs through over 280 online PD courses in 20 different subject areas for K-12 teachers. Everything is online and self-paced, and you have 6 months to complete the course. Right now, you can save 20% off any course with the code TRUTH. That's less than $120 per graduate credit hour. To learn more, visit advancementcourses.com. Teachers, listen up. If you're looking to lift up your students in a new way, then you've got to check out the Redbird Adaptive Math and ELA program. Redbird bundles from McGraw-Hill are as little as $40 for the year per 5 students and covers curriculum in grades 3-8. That's $40 for the year. The Redbird curriculum features the latest in adaptive instruction, gamification, and digital project-based learning to meet both national and state standards. Accelerate your students' learning with something different and fun. Check out Redbird today. Go to mheonline.com/redbird1 and get $5 off your classroom bundle. That's MHE for McGraw-Hill Education, online.com/redbird1. Remember, Redbird bundles are as little as $40 for the year for 5 students, making it perfect for intervention or acceleration. Check out Redbird today at mheonline.com/redbird1 and get $5 off your classroom bundle. That's MHE for McGraw-Hill Education, online.com/redbird1. So we are now approaching the end of the podcast season. This is the last episode of season 13 of Truth for Teachers, and I thought it made sense to use this app to talk about regrouping after a chaotic school year and figuring out what's next. Now, here's one really cool thing that I wanted to tell you that is related to that. Even though this is the last episode of the podcast season, we'll be kicking off season 14 in early August. There will still be lots of new resources and support for you through Truth for Teachers all summer long. And that's different from what I normally do. I always take a break from creating new articles and podcasts in June and July. That way I can focus on other projects, especially the 40-hour Teacher Workweek program, which kicks off each summer. However, this year I am in the process of transitioning my website from thecornerstoneforteachers.com over to truthforteachers.com. So it's going to match the podcast now, finally. I created the original version of the site back in 2003. So it has gone through a lot of different iterations over the past nearly 20 years. And I am super excited about what's next, which is embracing the Truth for Teachers focus and creating a collective of classroom practitioners who will be sharing diverse experiences and perspectives on the topics that I alone usually tackle. So even though I personally won't be writing new articles or podcast apps this summer during my break, this new writing team will be, and the team is going to have seasonal themes that we're focused on. This is going to start over the summer, and it will continue forward for the foreseeable future, definitely into the new school year. So Truth for Teachers writers will take a loose, broad topic, and each person will tackle a different aspect of it, from mindset to productivity to organization to equity and so on. So our very first theme for the Truth for Teachers team, starting this summer, is regrouping. And we'll be talking about all that regrouping encompasses and what it means to various teachers, from self-care to reflection to getting organized to creating an inspiring vision for the fall to preparing for the coming school year and more. So I'm going to use this episode to kick off that theme and talk about what regrouping means to me. And I'll offer a plan to help you regroup between these two school years, the one that's about to wrap up and the one that's coming. I think we all need a time of recovery and preparation. That in-between time this summer, I think it's going to be more essential and critical this year than ever before. and this plan will really help you make the most of it. The summer plan that I'm suggesting to help you regroup is three-pronged: taking a break from thinking about work, reflecting on what you learned about yourself and your teaching, and daydreaming and reimagining the future. So let's talk about each one of these individually. We'll begin with talking about taking a break from thinking about work. Now, you might remember that I took a sabbatical in December, and I'm telling you, that month of not even thinking about anything related to education was transformational for me. There is no way I would be able to do everything that I'm doing right now with Truth for Teachers and 40-hour leadership and 40-hour instructional coaches if I had not taken that time to regroup. Now, summer is my busiest time of year. I work more in the summer than any other time because my job is supporting teachers. And summer is a big time for PD and webinars and back-to-school trainings and so on. But you have several weeks off, unpaid, that I encourage you to use at least a part of for not thinking about work. You're not getting paid to work, so it's okay to not be thinking about work. I'm going to guide you through your own sabbatical next December during the 2 weeks or so that you have off for the holidays, even if it's 10 days, however long you have, so you can have a mental break from work twice a year. You'll have one this summer, which I'm about to talk about, and then when we get to December, we'll talk about a sabbatical for that time period too. So for now, I want you to actually schedule in time in your calendar to not think about anything related to school for the summer. Choose a week or two or four or whatever feels right to you. This is going to be a time in which teaching does not exist. When thoughts about your next group of students or your curriculum or whatever pop into your mind, you can just dismiss them and then distract yourself with something that you do want to think about. You are going to actively choose thoughts that are not about school. And you might find during this period, as I did, that when you're not thinking about work, creative ideas and problem solving come to you naturally. I experimented with this a little bit during my sabbatical. Sometimes I would just give into it. I would just say, okay, this brainstorm is coming to me. I'm going to just go ahead and think it through. I'll write down all my ideas so I won't forget, and then I'll think about other things. Other times, I refocused on the things that I wanted to be contemplating, and I just distracted myself right away. So what I found worked really well was just following my intuition, and that's what I encourage you to do here too. When the thinking about work feels light and easy, exciting, when it's energizing in your body and you're enjoying thinking about it and you like this train of thought and it's making you feel great, go with that. Go ahead and brainstorm. Write it down, and then you can come back to it once your time for regrouping is over. But when your thinking about work feels heavy, when it feels dark, when it feels stressful, like a weight on your shoulders, that's a sign, let those thoughts about work go. Let's just be present in the moment here. And you can worry about all those things you need to worry about at another time. This is a designated time for not thinking about work. You're going to choose a time this summer in which school does not exist. Mark that time off on your calendar and look forward to a true mental and emotional break from work, which is honestly the most important thing. I think that it's always useful to do that, but especially after this particular school year, which took a huge emotional toll on, I believe, all of us. Some people seem to be doing okay, but you know what? We don't always recognize the impact of trauma until we slow down and get quiet. And we can't heal from that trauma until we have the space to grieve losses and really process everything that has happened over the past. You might think you're doing just fine until you try to really rest. So be prepared for that. Be prepared that this might be a little trickier than what you think it is, that some emotions may come up that you didn't think were even there. Give yourself space and time this summer to sleep more, to accomplish less, to be less ambitious, less productive. You need days for that this summer because you are a human. You are not a machine. So get those no thinking about work days scheduled in your calendar as a mental vacation. That's the first part of regrouping. The second part of regrouping this summer is reflecting on what you learned about yourself and your teaching. So some people like to journal. Some people like to leave themselves voice memos on their phone so they can just talk and you don't have to write anything down. They can just be doing other things and sharing their thoughts out loud. I don't think you have to make this any kind of formal exercise unless you enjoy that, unless you like having a regular journaling practice where you show up at the same time every day, or you write for 15 minutes, or you sit in this one spot, this one chair in your house, and that's where you reflect. You could do that if you like it, but just allow yourself some time to reflect. I find that I do my best reflecting when I'm in nature, and especially when I'm going for walks. So I try not to play any podcasts or any music, and I just stay present in the moment. And somehow that physical activity just spurs my brain to think outside the box, and I often find I come home with lots of personal realizations. So whatever this time looks like for you, think about what you learned about yourself. At the beginning of the pandemic, I encourage you to really focus on what kind of person is this pandemic shaping me into. Don't focus on what you could do, couldn't do, what you missed out on, all those kinds of things. That's depressing. What kind of person are you becoming? And now that we're heading toward the end of things, where the end is in sight here, where we can find a post-pandemic world, some sense of normalcy that doesn't involve all these different restrictions, what kind of person have you become? What new learnings and understandings have you had about yourself over the past year or so? What new skills and mindsets have you developed? What do you now understand about your personality and preferences and temperament that you didn't know before? Knowing yourself as a person is such an important part of knowing yourself as a teacher. Your lens becomes your practice. It shapes what you value in the curriculum and how you run your classroom. And we all have blind spots. We all have things that we don't realize about ourselves. So really taking notice of who you are, what you like, what you don't like, what triggers you emotionally to anger or sadness, all these kinds of things will help you truly know and accept yourself. And when you understand your own needs, you're going to be able to care for yourself so much better. You'll know, for example, the limit for you on Zoom meetings and the signs in your body and your mind that you're experiencing Zoom fatigue. And you'll know what kinds of activities help you feel better. When you know yourself and you know your own needs, you can better make sure those needs are met and therefore be better prepared to show up as your best self for your students. As part of this reflection, you may want to also think about what teaching practices were really stressful for you this year and that you want to find ways to streamline. Think about the parts of your job that you absolutely hate and focus on how to create boundaries for them and simplify. And you may want to go back and listen to the episode that I did with Amy Stowes. It's episode 226 called 7 Takeaways from This School Year That Will Simplify Teaching from Now On. And she does some really awesome reflecting in that episode about what worked and what she wants to carry over to the next school year. So regrouping this summer means taking a mental break from work, reflecting on the past year and who you've become as a person, and finally, daydreaming and reimagining the future. Now, I know reimagining is a word that has been so overused, but stick with me here because it actually applies. The reason that I think it is important to reflect this summer as part of the regrouping process between school years is that we are in a transitional time in the field of education. We're not quite at post-pandemic teaching, but we can see the light at the end of the tunnel. And that means there's going to be a lot of talk about what expectations to keep and what to let go of. What parts of pre-pandemic teaching do we want to try to return to? What parts of remote and hybrid learning are here to stay? What does the future of education look like? And people in your district are going to have their own ideas here. Everybody's going to have their own ideas, right? And they're going to like give them to you, and then you're going to try to, you know, fit these expectations into everything else that's on your plate. I don't want you to just accept their vision. You know yourself, you know your students, and you know your classroom best. I want you to have your own vision for what you want to focus on with kids and what practices you want to let go of. See, your vision for your teaching is independent of that of your district. You could transfer to another school at any time, and who you are comes with you. Know who you are and what you value in your teaching. And this is also important because there will undoubtedly be many new expectations placed on you in the fall. And you need to be in a headspace to know which ones to wholeheartedly embrace, which ones to push back on, and which ones to adapt and simplify so they actually make sense. Creating practices of reflection will help you make those decisions. The confidence to say, I'm not doing that, or I'm going to do that a different way, comes from knowing that you're doing the things that make the biggest impact for kids. And if you don't uncover what those practices are, if you don't know what things you're doing actually do matter and what does make a difference, then you're always going to feel guilty when you create boundaries. It's really hard to say no because you're not sure what things you should be actually saying no to and what you might regret saying no to. So give yourself some time this summer to not think about work and get some distance from education. And then once you've had a break from thinking about it, I think you will find that you land on greater clarity and more creative solutions. We all want this reimagining that has been so hyped up for the past year to actually happen. So far, very few districts have actually reimagined education. So don't wait for them to do it. I want you to reimagine teaching and learning for yourself. And that way, you're not blindly following someone else's vision, especially when that someone else is not even an educator, doesn't even understand the job. They're just some politician off someplace who's deciding what teachers should and shouldn't be doing. You need to know what matters to you and your students. What really makes a difference so that you can have the confidence to root yourself down into that vision next fall and stand firm in what you know is important. Now, if you want support through this and practical strategies, here's what I'm going to be offering to you. I'm going to be doing a live webinar this summer. I haven't done those in a couple years, so I'm really excited about this. I haven't finalized the exact topic yet, but it's going to be around crafting an inspiring vision for fall. It's going to be a lot of the stuff I've shared here, like kind of taking this as a springboard and looking at the practical steps there about how to get yourself in this headspace where you know what you're focusing on in the fall. So there's going to be a whole live free training on this, regrouping and transition period. Also, keep an eye out for those articles I talked about at the beginning. Truth for Teachers writers are going to be focusing on the topic, the theme of regrouping this summer. So lots of your fellow educators are going to be sharing their thoughts and their strategies on it. And I will be sharing those on social media. So if you follow Angela Watson on Twitter, Facebook, or Instagram, you will be able to see some of the posts that way. And if you're not really into social media, you're trying to limit your time, I also have an email list with messages that come out each Sunday night. So it's just like a message of encouragement and inspiration and, you know, something to kind of help you through the week ahead. So you can go to truthforteachers.com to sign up or, again, find Angela Watson on social media. If you are considering a transition out of teaching, I do want to mention this really quick because I know that a lot of folks are really thinking about what are their next steps and they don't feel like they want to stay in the classroom. If that's you, check out Daphne Williams' Teacher Career Coach. She has a course and she has a free podcast. So I will put the link to Daphne's resources in the show notes. She has tons of support there to help you figure out what's next for you professionally if you think you might need a change. And of course, you can always check out the 40-hour Teacher Workweek program this summer. If you want support in streamlining in the new school year, it really does walk you step by step through the challenges of each month of the year. We start with back-to-school prep, to report card and conference time, to rebooting after the winter holidays, to ending the school year strong. So whatever's coming next, you don't have to do it alone. And regardless of whether you join my program or not, please make sure you're finding even a small community of like-minded teachers that can help you share this workload and brainstorm solutions together. So the 40-hour Teacher Workweek program is open to new members from June 13th to July 15th. There will also be the new 40-hour leadership and 40-hour instructional coaching courses coming out this summer. You can go to 40htw.com to learn more about any of these. So it's 40htw.com. We do offer scholarships, and we're doing a membership giveaway, too, for the Teacher Work Week. So if you're not able to get funding and you don't want to pay out of pocket, check that out, too, 40htw.com. So that's the kickoff here for our regrouping. This is the last podcast episode of the season, but it's not the last resource from Truth for Teachers about regrouping that's coming out. Make sure you follow what's happening with Truth for Teachers this summer because these teachers have some awesome ideas to share with you. Have a wonderful break, and remember, take time for regrouping, for giving yourself a mental break from work, for reflecting on the past year of growth, and for daydreaming about the future and your vision for the work ahead. You can do this. And remember, it's not going to be easy. It's going to be